Hey, what is going on, guys? RVZ Stealth here, and in today's video, we're gonna be taking a look at the new strong and weak picks heading into patch 8.5. So as I've been doing for the past few patches now, I'm gonna give each of the champion changes a rating out of 5, and 5 being that the change is super impactful, and then 1 being that the change is not really gonna affect them too much. And then I will also give them an up or down arrow based on if the change is a buff or a nerf. So that being said, guys, let's get started. So first up here, the first change we're going to take a look at is to Azir. Now, Azir is getting a little change, and I think this one is more targeted towards the competitive scene because Azir's been nerfed quite a few times over the past few patches, and his state in solo queue right now isn't that great. He isn't performing super well, so I think this change will affect him like more for solo queue than the competitive scene. They're nerfing his poke damage here in the early game, and you do max your Q out first there on Azir, so this will hurt his ability to poke a little bit in the laning phase. I don't think this is the end of the world though for Azir. I'm not giving it a super crazy rating or anything. I'm only giving it a 2. I think that if you still know how to play Azir well and you can play him to his highest level, then this change shouldn't affect him too much. So next up, there's two different changes to Galio here. He's got a cooldown increase on his Q, and he's also got a mana increase on his Q. So when you take a look at these changes here, I think the mana increase on his Q is the big one because it's increased by 40 mana there at rank 5. And because this ability, it is a pretty spammy ability and you want to be using it to clear the waves out, it is Galio's main wave clear ability, or it's his only wave clear ability really. So I think that this change might change up the itemization for Galio. You might have to build like one more mana item on him. We might see Galio players going tier now in the next patch, but this is definitely gonna put a pretty big hit to his mana pool, and it will affect his ability to wave clear in the early game. So it looks like Jhin is finally getting some decent buffs here. He's been in a pretty bad state for the past few patches now, and I'm giving this one a rating of 3 here because I think this one should be enough to at least bring him back up into a playable state for next patch. So what they're doing is the passive's AD is getting increased from 2 to 40% total up to 4 to 44% total, and that is based on level. His Q's AD ratio is also getting increased there up by 10% at rank 5, and then his W is now getting root off of all of the type of damage that Jhin deals. So if he hits the enemy with a Q, then he can proc the root off of that. If he hits his ultimate, then he can proc the root off of that. So overall, I think these are pretty nice changes to Jhin here, and all three of them combined should be enough to bring him back into a decent spot for 8.5. So Nocturne is getting a few decent buffs in this next patch, but I'm only giving this one a 2 rating because even though they are some pretty good buffs, I really don't think they're going to be enough to bring Nocturne back into the meta. So he's getting two different changes to his passive. When you are auto attacking as Nocturne, the cooldown on your passive is now going to be reduced per every auto attack by 2 seconds instead of 1, and the base healing is also getting increased there on his passive. Now the interesting one here, in my opinion, is to his ultimate. The duration that the enemies have reduced vision is being increased from 4 seconds up to 6 seconds. So overall, I think because we haven't seen a ton of Nocturne recently, it's kind of hard to tell how influential these changes will be. We might see more Nocturne players end up going Bloodraiser now and actually utilizing this change to his passive there, and he might become a really strong just dueling champion in the early to mid game, but I'm only giving this one a 2 right now just because it is hard to tell based on just seeing no Nocturne over the past few months how strong these changes will actually make him. So similar to Nocturne, Olaf is also getting 3 different changes in next patch. He's getting a change to his E to where the AD ratio is getting increased, his E's cooldown is getting lowered, and then his ultimate is kind of getting a weird change here to where they're nerfing it for tank Olaf, but they're buffing it if you're building full AD Olaf. So the attack damage you get when you use your ultimate is getting changed from just a base to they're lowering the base, and they're now giving it a total AD ratio on it. So this means that if you are going to be building like AD Olaf and you're playing him kind of like assassin style, then this will be a buff to the damage on his ultimate. But if you are playing the traditional like tank Olaf where you build like maybe one damage item and then go full tank after that, then the AD you get from your ultimate is going to be lower in this next patch. So overall, I'm just giving this one a 2 rating here, because even though these do seem like decent buffs to Olaf, I feel like these will be just placebo buffs and they're not really going to do too much for him. So Rengar is getting a few different changes as well. This one is getting a 3 rating here because in Rengar's state right now, he isn't really performing super good. So I think that these buffs will bring him a little bit more in line and they should be pretty impactful for him. So the lockout time before Rengar can cast empowered spells is being reduced from 0.25 seconds down to 0.1 seconds. The ferocity falloff timer is being increased from 6 seconds up to 8 seconds. His Q is getting a change to where the scaling on it is being reduced in the early game, but it's going to be increased in the late game. So this means that late game Rengar, his Q is going to deal more damage, and then his R's true vision is now going to linger until the end of the leap. So this is getting a 3 rating here, mainly because I don't think it's enough to bring him into the meta and make him a super top tier jungler, but I also think that these changes will be enough to put him into a more viable spot for 8.5. Ryze is getting a few different changes in this next patch. Now, I'm labeling this one as a nerf here, but it kind of depends on how you look at it and to which lane you're going to be playing Ryze as to whether or not this would be a nerf or a buff. So his E's damage is getting increased by 20 at rank 1. So in melee matchups to where you can poke in the early game, I think this change will be pretty nice for Ryze, and it will definitely increase his ability to bully in the early game. So for top lane Ryze, I think this will be a pretty big buff. Now his E is now only going to deal 50% damage upon spreading though. So in mid lane matchups to where you want to shove in the early game and you want to base for that early tier, I think this will be a pretty big nerf to Ryze. It kind of depends on how big this is going to hit his wave clear in the early game. But if it does end up hitting his ability to shove and look for that early base, then I think this change could be even like a 3 or a 4 rating for Ryze mid lane. His ultimate's cooldown is being increased from 120 seconds up to 180 seconds, but don't look too much into that change for solo queue because you're honestly not even going to be using Ryze's ultimate until level 11 a lot of the time, and it just does require way too much coordination to be able to use it for solo queue for that nerf to actually mean anything. So the change to his E there though is going to be the big one, and I think that if you're playing top lane Ryze to where you don't really need an early base timing and you are also running the teleport, then I don't think this should really affect him too much. But if you're playing mid lane Ryze and you're in a ranged matchup to where you do really need to shove in the early game and get that base for that early tier, then I think this will definitely impact him quite a bit. So Swain is getting 2 different changes in next patch. He's getting a buff to his Q to where the cooldown is being lowered by 2 seconds at rank 1. So that is definitely going to increase Swain's ability to bully, especially in melee matchups in the early game. And then his W's radius is being increased from 265 units up to 325 units. So I think that these changes will be enough to actually make Swain a pretty top tier top lane pick in this next patch, especially in melee matchups, because his ability to bully there with his Q on that short of a cooldown now should be really nice in 8.5. So Tristana is getting a few different changes in 8.5. She's getting a change to where her attack range is getting lowered from 550 down to 525. Now to kind of compensate for this change, her passive, the range that you get from it, is being increased by 1 range per level. And then her W's damage is being increased from 60 at rank 1 up to 85. So that's a 25 damage increase there. So in lanes to where you want to be playing super aggro in the early game, if you're in like a Blitz lane or Leona lane and you're going to be looking for a level 2 all in, then this will definitely increase her ability to look for a snowball in the early game. Now I really don't think that the change to her attack range is going to be that bad. You are definitely going to notice it in the early game there, but once you do reach the mid to late game, because of the Tristana passive getting buffed, it isn't going to be as noticeable. So it is hard to judge based on like a range nerf as to how much it's going to affect a champion, but I'm giving this one a 2 rating here because of that buff as well there to her W. I don't think these changes are going to affect her too much. So Skarner is getting hit with a small nerf in next patch. He's getting a stun duration decrease on his E from 1.5 seconds down to 1.25 seconds. Now this is getting a 1 rating here because I don't think this one should affect Skarner too much. I do think that it might drop him in power like a little bit, but I really don't think it's going to change his placement on the tier list for 8.5. So Zoe is getting quite a few different compensation buffs in 8.5. She got way too many nerfs in 8.4, so it looks like they're trying to bring her back in line now in 8.5. If you want to pause the video and take a look at all the changes, then you can, but basically a TLDR of the changes is her Q's damage and her W's damage are both getting increased. And I am giving these changes a 4 rating here because I think these changes will bring Zoe back into a pretty good spot for 8.5. There are a lot of different changes here though, so it's hard to tell whether or not she's going to be top tier or not in 8.5, but these are definitely some pretty nice buffs here to Zoe. So Cloud Dragon is getting a change to where it's now going to give you some in-combat movement speed. Now this movement speed is definitely pretty low. It's only going to be 2%, 4%, and then 6% depending on how many drakes you have. But I do think for certain champions, this will be nice. If you're taking Celerity, then this will be a buff to those champions, and just a mobile champions in general will like these changes. But I am only giving this a 2 rating here because chances are you're only going to be getting like 1 or 2 Cloud Dragon in the game, and like 2% movement speed isn't gonna mean a whole lot in the grand scheme of things. So Aftershock is getting a pretty substantial nerf in this next patch. The cooldown is being increased from 20 seconds up to 35 seconds. Now what this means here is a nerf to tank champions in the top lane and in the support role. And this means that bruiser champions are going to have a little bit of a better time in 8.5. It will give them a bigger window now to look for a trade when that Aftershock is on cooldown. And this is definitely going to be a pretty good change here because there's also some press the attack buffs as well that we're going to take a look at in a moment. Now down in the support role, I think that we might see more support champions go towards Guardian now in next patch. I don't think this is going to make Aftershock completely worthless in 8.5, but almost doubling the cooldown there on the rune is definitely a pretty substantial nerf. And then press the attack is getting a change to where the vulnerable damage is being increased from 4% all the way up to 8% there in the early rank. So this is definitely a nice change here for these bruiser champions in the top lane. Along with that Aftershock nerf, I think this will make a lot of bruiser champions a lot stronger here in 8.5. And then lastly here, the final change we're going to take a look at heading into 8.5 is to the Hextech GLP item. So this item is the one that is underperforming, at least compared to Archangels and to Ludens right now. So it's not too much of a surprise that it is getting buffed in 8.5. So the active damage on it is being increased, and then the active slow is also being increased. So I think this will bring it into a spot to where on certain champions, this will be a good option now. So on picks like the Talia, I think this will be a pretty good option in this next patch. These changes definitely will not make it like a must buy item or anything, and on champions that are already buying Archangels and Ludens, on the majority of them you're still going to be going Archangel and Ludens. I just think on a select few mid laners this is going to be a pretty nice buff. So that is going to be all for this video, guys. This patch was definitely smaller than the ones we've had in the past, and I don't think there's really too many meta shifting changes in this next patch, but there's definitely some interesting ones in there, and I think that a few different champions will definitely get stronger and weaker in 8.5. But with that being said, guys, if you did enjoy this video, then be sure to leave a like, subscribe if you have yet to already. So thanks for watching, have an awesome day, and I will see you in my next video.